Dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel Vidya for Success. In this video, let us continue our study on the structural organization of cockroach. As in our last video, we have discussed about morphology of cockroach. As in today's class, let us discuss about mouth parts of cockroach. So mouth part is very essential because the initial chewing and biting of food takes place in this particular part. So mouth part is located in the region of head. So we have seen in the head region, pair of compound eyes are present and pair of antenna are present, and also we can see the mouth part, right? So mouth part in the cockroach is made out of number of segments. So there are different segments are present in the mouth part to perform their own function. So the main function of the mouth part is biting and chewing of the food, right? So let us now study about the mouth parts of cockroach. So the first segment what we can see in the mouth part is labrum. So labrum is called as the upper lip. So upper lip in the cockroach is formed by labrum, right? You can notice in the diagram. So the first segment what we are observing in the mouth part, that is nothing but labrum. It is commonly called as upper lip. And a paired structure we can see, just they are enclosed by the labrum. So very next to the labrum we have a paired structure. They are named as mandible. So what is the function of mandible? So mandible are the strongest mouth part in the cockroach. So this mouth part is actually used for biting and chewing of food, right? So cockroach is an omnivorous. It eat all sorts of food. So it eat plant food as well as animal food. So when the mouth is intaking the food, it is initially get chewed by one of the mouth part, that is called as mandible. So in order to bite and chew the food, there are pair of structures are present. Those pair of structures are named as mandible, right? And one more pair structure we can see in the mouth part. Those are named as maxillae. So maxillae are present very next to the mandible. These are also paired structure. What is the function of maxillae? So these pair of structures are used to hold and manipulate food. So when the mandible is chewing and biting the food, there is some structure needed to hold the food in a proper position, right? So the maxillae perform that function. So maxillae hold and manipulate the food so that it can be chewed and sliced by mandible. Then we can also see the lower lip in the mouth part, that is named as labium. So labium is the lower lip of cockroach, and within the cavity, within the cavity region, the buccal cavity region, so there is a small tongue like structure is present, that is called as hypopharynx. So hypopharynx is the median flexible lobe acting as a tongue. So it just helps in flipping the food towards the further part of the alimentary canal. So this is about the mouth part of cockroach. So we have talked about the labrum. Labrum is the upper lip. Then one pair structure is present very next to the labrum, that is called as a mandible. And next to the mandible, one more paired structure is present, that is called as maxillae. Then the lower lip is called as labium. Then a small flexible median lobe is present that act as a tongue, that is named as hypopharynx. So this is about the mouth parts of cockroach. Yes, now let us study about the anatomy. So the first anatomy we are going to start with is digestive system of cockroach. So the digestive system is the system formed by different organs. So there are different organs forming the digestive system. So the main function of the digestive system is the digestion and absorption of food, right? So in order to digest the food, the complete digestive system we can see in the cockroach. What do you mean by complete digestive system? So the digestive system with two openings is called as complete digestive system. So the one opening is present towards the anterior region and the another opening is present towards the posterior region. So because the digestive system consists of two openings, it is called as complete digestive system, right? So the digestive system is also called as alimentary canal and it is also named as GERD. So these are the different terminology what we use for the digestive system. So in the examination, they may ask you to explain the alimentary canal or GERD of cockroach. So alimentary canal or GERD is nothing but what? Digestive system, right? So the digestive system is actually located in the body cavity region. So body cavity is present in the organism. So within the body cavity, alimentary canal is present. So the alimentary canal is divided into three regions. So the first region is called as foregut, and the second region is called as midgut, and the third region is called as hindgut. So these are the three different regions of alimentary canal. So foregut consists of some of the organs. So these organs are actually located towards the anterior end of the animal. So because these organs of the alimentary canal, they are located towards the anterior end, those organs are called as the part of foregut. Clear? So the some organs are present in the foregut. They are located towards the anterior end of the animal. And the foregut is followed by midgut. And midgut is followed by the last region that is called as hindgut. So why it is called as hindgut? Because it is located towards the posterior end of the animal. So because of this, it is called as hindgut. So let us now talk about some of the organs present in the foregut, midgut and hindgut. So first let us start with the foregut. So foregut is the first part of the alimentary canal. That means the first region of the alimentary canal. So it starts with mouth. So mouth is the first part of the foregut. What is the function of mouth? So mouth is the part from where the food is taken in. So in order to take the food towards the inner region of the alimentary canal, so there is a first part we can see in the foregut that is called as mouth. So mouth is a part from where the intaking of food takes place, right? So the mouth is followed by a short tube-like structure that is called as pharynx. So you can see in the diagram, pharynx is labeled. So pharynx is a short tubular structure, tube-like structure. It is present very next to the mouth. Mouth is connected with the pharynx, right? What is the function of pharynx? So pharynx consists of some of the glands. Pharyngeal glands are present in the pharynx, right? So these glands secrete some of the fluid. That means the mucus is get secreted by the pharyngeal gland. So it makes the mouth, food slippery, right? So something is needed to make the food slippery so that food can easily move to the inner part of the alimentary canal. So in order to make the food slippery, there are some glands are present in the pharynx. They secrete mucus. So it makes the food slippery so that food can easily move into the further part of the alimentary canal, right? And pharynx is followed by a narrow tubular passage. That tubular passage is called as esophagus. So esophagus is called as narrow tubular structure, or it is called as a food pipe, right? So food is carried to the further part of the alimentary canal through a narrow tubular structure that is named as esophagus. Clear? So from the pharynx, the food moved towards the esophagus. So esophagus is act as a food pipe. So through the esophagus, the food will be flipped towards the further part of the alimentary canal. So this is just a narrow passage through which the food enters into the further part of the alimentary canal. So what is the next part of the foregut? So very next to the esophagus, crop is located. So crop is the organ in the digestive system that is looking very prominent part in the diagram, right? So this is the largest part of the alimentary canal, and you can see the characteristic shape of the crop. So crop is actually a sac-like structure. So this sac-like structure actually stores the food temporarily. So all sorts of food taken by the cockroach does not directly get enter into the intestine, right? So food is temporarily get stored in one of the organ. That organ is called as crop. So this is the temporary storage area, so that food is properly get mixed and it is temporarily get stored in one of the organ that is named as crop. So it is used for storage of food. Then bit by bit from the crop, the food will be moved towards the one more part of the foregut that is called as gizzard. So gizzard is muscular structure, muscular organ. This is actually made out of muscles. So what is the function of muscle? So muscle helps in contraction and relaxation. That means some kind of movement showed by the muscle present in the gizzard, right? So this muscular organ consists of chitinaceous plates called teeth. So there are 6 chitinaceous plates are present in the gizzard, right? So this mainly helps in the grinding of food particle. So the grinding of food is takes place by the chitinaceous plates present in the gizzard, so that the grinding procedure, the grinding of food is actually takes place in one of the organ of foregut that is called as gizzard. So what is there in the gizzard in order to grind the food? It consists of chitinaceous plate called as teeth. So there are 6 chitinaceous plates are present in the gizzard to grind the food particles, right? So this is about the foregut region. So we have started our discussion from mouth to till the gizzard. So these are the different organs present in the foregut of the cockroach. They perform different function, right? And there is a junction we can see that actually joins the foregut with the midgut, because foregut is followed by which part of the digestive system? That is midgut, right? So the junction where the foregut joins with the midgut, in that particular region we can see the finger like projections. They are not thread like structure, they are little large in their size, so that they are the finger like projections are named as hepatic cecum, right? So there are 6 to 8 blind tubules are located at the junction of foregut and midgut. So those tubular structure or the finger like projections are called as hepatic cecum. What is the function of these structure? Why hepatic cecum are present at the junction of foregut and midgut? So till now we have seen there is no proper digestion of food taken place in the alimentary canal. So just the simplification of food takes place in the some organs of the foregut region, right? So from the gizzard, the grinded food will move towards the further part of alimentary canal where actually the digestion and absorption of food takes place. So in order to digest and absorb the food material, some of the enzymes are very essential. So without enzymes, there is no digestion of food, there is no absorption of food, right? So hepatic cecum secretes digestive juices. So digestive juice is actually required for the complete digestion of food. So the main function of hepatic cecum is it secretes digestive juice required for the digestion of food material, right? So as soon as the digestive juice is secreted by the hepatic cecum, they are get released into the midgut region. So midgut is the main part of the alimentary canal where the digestion and absorption of food takes place. So the complete digestion of food as well as absorption of nutrient simplified food material takes place in one of the part of the alimentary canal, that is nothing but midgut. Right? So midgut is narrow and it is short compared to the hindgut in cockroach. Right? So midgut is followed by hindgut. So hindgut, you can see it starts from ileum, and the junction where the midgut joins with the hindgut, in that particular region we can see the small thread like structures. What are those thread like structures? They are nothing but Malpighian tubules. So the Malpighian tubules are yellow colored thread like structure. So their number nearly ranges from 100 to 150. So 100 to 150 Malpighian tubules are present at the junction of midgut and hindgut. So junction is nothing but where the midgut joins with the hindgut, that particular region is called as junction, right? So in that junction we can see 100 to 150 number of Malpighian tubules. So what is the function of Malpighian tubule? So it absorbs the waste from the hemolymph region. So from the hemolymph region, some of the waste materials, they are get absorbed by the tubular structures. They are called as Malpighian tubule. What do you mean by hemolymph? So in case of a cockroach, the lymph is present that is actually mixed with hemo. That means that is mixed with the blood. Right? So the white blood is present in the cockroach, so that is mixed with the lymph. So that is a kind of body fluid. So within the body fluid we can see some of the impurities, they are added by some of the metabolic activity taken place by the cockroach. Right? So those impurities, the nitrogenous waste materials, they are get absorbed by one of the part tubular structure present in the digestive system. So those structures are nothing but Malpighian tubules. So Malpighian tubules absorbs the waste present in the hemolymph. Right? Is the hindgut consists of the first part that is called as ileum. So ileum followed by colon. So colon is followed by rectum. So the ileum, colon and rectum, they are the different parts of the hindgut. So the first part is ileum. So ileum connected with the ileum is the first part of the hindgut. It is get connected with the foregut. So the solid undigested food material, what is sent from the midgut region, is initially get collected in the region that is called as ileum. So here the some of the left out nutrients are get absorbed, and the solid waste material will be moved towards the further part of the hindgut that is called as colon, and from the colon the solid undigested food is get stored in the rectum. So rectum is the last part of hindgut. So the rectum opens out through anus, so that solid undigested waste material can be removed through the opening present at the posterior region of the alimentary canal, that is called as anus, right? So anus is the opening present at the posterior end of cockroach. So from where the solid undigested waste ejects out from the body, right? So this is about the digestive system of cockroach, right? So we have seen the three different regions of the digestive system in the cockroach. The first region is called as the foregut, and second region is called as midgut, and the third region is called as hindgut. And the one thing you should understand here is the foregut is covered on outside by cuticle. So cuticle is present on the outer side, especially in the foregut region. That means from pharynx region to till the gizzard, there is a outer protective covering we can see in the alimentary canal of cockroach, that is called as cuticle. So it protects the foregut region, right? So children, Here in this concept, you have to practice a diagram. Diagram is very important. So this has been asked in the examination many times, so that you have to practice the diagram with labeling, right? And then you go with the characteristic features of the digestive system.